फेरोमैग्नेटिज्म। फेरोमैग्नेटिक सब्सटेंसेस आर दोज व्हिच गेट स्ट्रांगली मैग्नेटाइज्ड व्हेन प्लेस्ड इन एन एक्सटर्नल मैग्नेटिक फील्ड। इन ए फेरोमैग्नेटिक मटेरियल द फील्ड लाइन्स आर हाईली कॉन्सेंट्रेटेड। देर आर टू टाइप्स ऑफ फेरोमैग्नेटिक मटेरियल्स। नंबर वन हार्ड फेरोमैग्नेटिक मटेरियल्स, नंबर टू सॉफ्ट फेरोमैग्नेटिक मटेरियल्स। What are hard ferromagnetic materials? The ferromagnetic material in which the magnetization persists when the external field is removed is called hard ferromagnetic materials or hard ferromagnets. Example, Alnico, an alloy of iron, aluminium, nickel, cobalt, and copper. Number two, ferromagnetic materials are the naturally occurring lodestone. The uses of ferromagnetic materials are in the making of permanent magnets, for example, compass needle. Soft ferromagnetic materials, the ferromagnetic material in which the magnetization disappears on removal of the external magnetic field is called soft ferromagnetic material. Examples of ferromagnetic materials are iron, cobalt, nickel, gadolinium, etc. Remember, the relative magnetic permeability of ferromagnetic material is very high, that is, it is greater than 1000. Now let us discuss the simple explanation about ferromagnetism. The individual atoms in a ferromagnetic material possesses a dipole moment. In the absence of external magnetic field, the dipole moments are randomly oriented. In the presence of external magnetic field, the dipoles aligned in the direction of the magnetic field. The dipoles form domains. The dipoles interact, or the domains interact with one another. The dipoles form domains and the domains interact with one another. Typical size of the domain is of the order of 1 millimeter. The domain contains about 10 to the power 11 atoms. The existence of domains and their motion in the magnetic field has been experimentally verified. The domains align to form a giant domain. You see in this picture, this is the domain in ferromagnetic materials, and in the presence of external field, the domain look like this. That is, the dipoles, individual dipoles in the domain, they align in a perfect order. But in the absence of magnetic field, there is no perfect order of the dipoles inside the domain. The domain structure disintegrates with temperature. At a high enough temperature, a ferromagnet becomes a paramagnet. The temperature of transition from ferromagnetic to paramagnetic is called Curie temperature. It is represented by the symbol TC. The table shows the Curie temperature of some ferromagnetic materials. That is, for cobalt, the Curie temperature is 1394 degree Kelvin. That means beyond 1394 degree Kelvin, the ferromagnetic cobalt becomes paramagnetic. Similarly, the Curie temperature of iron is 1043. The Curie temperature of iron oxide, ferric oxide, is 893 degree Kelvin. For nickel, it is 631 degree Kelvin. For gadolinium, it is 317 degree Kelvin. the susceptibility above the Curie temperature, that is the paramagnetic phase, is given by J equal to C divided by T minus TC. Here T is greater than TC and C is the Curie constant. Ferromagnetic hysteresis, the behavior of the material in a complete cycle of magnetization, is called hysteresis. Consider a unmagnetized material placed in a solenoid. By increasing the current, the magnetic intensity H increases, as a result of which the magnetic field B in the material rises. If we plot a graph taking magnetic intensity H along X-axis and magnetic field B along Y-axis, then the curve is called BH curve. This is the BH curve of the ferromagnetic material. In the X-axis, we take the magnetic intensity and the Y-axis, we take the magnetic field B. When the current is increased or magnetic intensity H is increased, the magnetic field B in the material rises and saturates at A. You see the rising of the magnetic field and the saturation of the magnetic field at the point A. If we decrease the magnetic field and reduces it to zero, then the value of the magnetic field will not be equal to zero. You see the value of the magnetic field B here. In this graph, the value of the magnetic field is about 1.2 Tesla. The value of B at which H is equal to zero is called retentivity. This is called retentivity or remanence, that is BR. Now reverse the current in the solenoid and increase the magnetic intensity. This is the reverse of the current and increase the magnetic intensity in the negative X direction. You see in this curve, the value of H, this is the value of H at which the magnetic field B is equal to zero. This is called coercivity. This point C is called coercivity. That is, for around HC value, around minus 90 ampere per meter, the magnetic field is equal to zero. When the reverse current is increased, if you further increase the reverse current, then the magnetic field will get saturated at about, here in this figure, about 1.5 Tesla. At about 1.5 Tesla, the magnetic field gets saturated. If you now reduce the current and you make the current again positive, or the magnetic intensity again positive, then you will get the curve. The curve will reach the point A. You see, the cycle you see in these dotted lines, this is the complete cycle or hysteresis cycle. This is called the hysteresis cycle of ferromagnetic material. So this amount of magnetism will be lost in a complete cycle of magnetization in a ferromagnetic material, and this is called the hysteresis loss. And it is very important that the curve OA, you see the blue curve, OA does not retrace itself as H is reduced.